Okay, now that we've upgraded the tutorial, we still need to set it up for TFT display. So to show you how to do that, first we're going to remove the power. Next, we're going to remove this LCD connector and this one, as well as this underneath and this. So I'm going to flip this over for a moment so you can see what's going on. And what we need to do is we need to attach the TF cable. So the TF cable, as I've said in the very first tutorial, will connect to the notched connector over here. And that's all you need to do on that side. Now the other side is a little bit more complex. So I'm going to show you the underside of the DuPont connector, and these edges are going to face inwards to the board. Now on this actual board, they connect over here to the TFT pins on the SKR. So you're going to be facing inwards, you're going to hold this pin out to the side for a moment, and you're going to place these pins down. Next, you're going to take the same pin facing the same way, and you're also going to mount it on the pin over here. So the next stage in this is we need to actually load firmware to make this work. So we need to connect the big side of the USB serial cable right here to the board to power it. I'm going to flip this over so it's easier to watch. And then I'm going to plug in the other side to the computer, and you may hear a beep. I'm actually going to take this out because it's no longer needed. Okay, in order to set this up for the TFT display, we need to go to the Marlin Firmware website. So we're going to type Marlin Firmware. We're going to press enter. Then we're going to click on the Marlin Firmware Home. And we're going to go to Download. And now that we have the latest release of 2.0.x, we're going to download that. Now this was recently released within the last week, so it may not be totally stable, but I'm guessing it's pretty close to being stable. So as soon as it finishes downloading, what we're going to do is we're going to open it in VS Code. But before we do that, we have to go to Show in Folder, right click, and extract all. And this may take a moment, so I'm going to stop the video. Okay, to start with, as you can see, we connected the USB to the SKR version 1.3. And we can see on the actual board that we have firmware loaded. I need you to note the time that you see here and date. Now we're going to go to VS Code. We're going to go to Add Folder. We're going to go to the Marlin folder. And we're going to open up Marlin 2.0.x. from the extracted folder that we have here. We're going to click Add. And while this is adding, I'm going to collapse some of these folders down so you can see everything. So the first thing that we want to do is go to the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, we want to do a search on SKR. And as you can see, we have the board underscore BigTree underscore SKR underscore B1 underscore 3. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. Next, we're going to collapse these folders, and we're going to go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, we're going to do a search on motherboard. We're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. B. We're going to paste what we just copied. Then we're going to scroll up, and I'm going to make note of this for you. The TFT35 defaults to the speed of 115 to 100, but in this case, we have it at a 250,000 bits per second. And I'm going to show you how to work around that, but if you don't want to work around it, you can always change it to 115-200 to deal with it. So up here, we're going to leave our serial port alone for the moment. And then we're going to go down to platform.io.ini, and we're going to change our default environment for our chipset from the Mega ATmega 2560 to the LPC 1768. And I want to go back to configuration.h to show you one other thing. If your board is not working, one of the reasons may be that your steppers are not configured. So you're going to do a search on A4988. And down here, you'll need to enable the steppers that you're using, being the X driver, the Y driver, the Z driver, and we'll say E0. It may not be the case for you, but who knows? So in order to upload this, we're going to press the upload button and let it compile and then upload to our board. Okay, now that the build is completed, to verify that it's built, we're going to scroll up, and as you can see, our chipset, being the LPC 1768, says successful. We're going to go over to the SD drive for the SKR version 1.3, and as you can see, we have a new file called firmware.bin, and note the time. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to disconnect the USB in a moment to show you what happens. And then we'll see what happens with the update in here. Okay, so I'm going to remove the USB. Now I'm going to replace it. And as you can see, it's booting up and says no printer attached. Now keep in mind, what we need to do is, because the speed, we don't know what it is, so I'm going to click on settings, and right now it says 115-200, but we're at 250,000 bits, so I'm going to click on that. And currently that doesn't fix the situation either. Oh, there it goes. It does fix the situation. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.